In this, hopefully very short episode of Finno-Greek machining, it's going to be a chamfering tool for the lathe. I'm milling something, and then I'm going to braze the silver solder or braze. Solder those carbide bits into that tool. Let's go on with this one so it doesn't really become a long video. The carbide bits are to be braced in a tool steel rod. Here I'm milling the end of this rod to have this 45 degree angle and also suitable relief angles on it. Here I am just eyeballing that the carbide bit fits into its place. It seems that a little bit more needs to be taken off, and then this side is okay. Although this carbide bit could be braced on top of this rod, it's better to mill a slot for it. The cutting forces on this tool steel are way more than I expected, so I check the tightness of these nuts. I also check that the slot is going to be suitably deep. Here I am checking that this carbide bit is hanging a little bit over the edge of the tool steel. I also make an additional slot for the silver solder. Thank you. Here I am removing the coating from the underside of the carbide bit to allow the brazing to attach to it. Now I'm applying flux to the flat attaching surface. The intention is sort of glue the carbide bit in place while it's brazing. Now I'm wiping off the excess flux. I also check that the bits are sitting in place. Now I am cutting suitable pieces of the silver solder. Well, this is the stuff I'm using here. It contains quite a lot of cadmium, which is considered of being hazardous. Well, this is not plutonium. The silver solder should be half buried in flux. This prevents it from oxidizing before it melts and migrates into the gap. I place the workpiece into cold oven. This prevents excessive bubbling from moving the bits when this kiln warms up. I will dial in 730 degrees Celsius, which is 100 degrees above the melting point of this silver solder. Oh yeah, this is the result. Well, I attached some pictures there, but yeah, it's attached actually. And well, yeah, it looks like a good usable tool. well, some 45 degree chamfers with this one, and I really these carbide inserts, these are meant for brazing, for to be brazed on some metal, not for to be changed later on. You just attach them to some with brazing, and then it stays there. And that carbide is a little bit special. It can be sharpened, really, really sharp. This is some sandpeak carbide, and it's really tough. Although I have a CBN wheel, this was really, didn't want to grind. So, I hope they stay. I can see that the soldering material has penetrated all the way under there, but I have experienced cases when it didn't attach to the iron. For some reason, carbide and iron and brazing, well, it sometimes doesn't attach. It wants to go to the carbide, but not on the iron. But that's actually the flux. Flux. I have a very bad flux. It's just this borax. And, I'm receiving a packet from USA, which is that black stuff. And after that we will see whether this works better. This one doesn't always work. In this case it seemed like it did. And yeah, the temperature, by the way, is really critical with this. If you heat it too much, the braze material will just boil off. Not good. Okay, anyway, in the next episode, hopefully we can go on with that rotating welding positioner, which I have been avoiding like it would be poisonous. Okay, well, yeah, so till then, see you!